Hey everybody, welcome back to Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today we're going to be taking a look at Omnivore, which is a read later service in the vein of Readwise Reader or Matter or Pocket. And the big differentiator I think this app has over those is it's completely free. And no, I don't mean free with a paid upgrade or free with a subscription to unlock the full functionality. It's completely free. There's no way to spend money in the app, and that's pretty rare these days. Eventually, this will probably not be the case, especially if you're using their official instance of Omnivore. You can self-host it. That's a whole other situation. It is open source if you are into that sort of thing, but we're just using the main Omnivore.app version today. I'm going to show you some of the cool things about it. I will say the UI has some quirks that make it a little painful to use, that make it feel just not perfect, not quite as nice as, in my opinion, Readwise and Matter, but it also has some really cool things, so we'll take a look at all that right now. Okay, so we're gonna start by just saving an article, and I'm gonna do that using the browser extension. I'm in Arc, so this is one that works in Chrome, any Chromium-based browser. There's also a Safari extension if you use Safari on the Mac, and on iOS, it's just the share sheet, like every other app. So we're just gonna save it. There you go. You can kind of see it flashes the page and kind of scrolls. I don't really know exactly what it's doing here, but long story short, if I go over to Omnivore now and reload the page, I should see the article I just saved, and it shows up right here. The most exciting thing, my favorite thing about Omnivore, though, is on the iPhone and iPad only. So let's switch over here and let's go to Omnivore. So you can see that article I just saved here at the top. I can tap into it. You get the nice reading view. I do find it parses a little worse than some of the other apps, so you get a lot more cruft in it. This one looks pretty good, though. So let's go ahead and hit the headphones icon to just do text-to-speech and listen to this article.
Google and Apple, the beginning, SMCO. Are Apple and Google competitors, or are they partners?
Now, I'm also going to say I am listening at 1.5x. You can change the speed to slower or faster than this if you want, but this gives you an idea.
Prior to the launch of the Android operating system, Apple and Google collaborated on many projects. Google Search was predominant on Apple products, including the, at the time, new iPhone. The iPhone also launched with support for Gmail and had native Google Maps and even YouTube. Google was a cornerstone supplier for the new smartphone.
Okay, so I'm going to pause it there, and it sounds really good. There's quite a few voices you can choose from, especially if English is your primary language. So if we go into the text-to-speech, you may have noticed it doesn't highlight as you go, as like a lot of the other apps do, so you kind of have to scroll around, which is kind of annoying, especially in long articles. If you're listening to it while you're walking or something, you kind of have to, and you want to highlight something, you kind of have to go in here and find it. We will actually highlight this first sentence here. Again, this will come back, so highlight. Cool. If I go into this, this does kind of scroll along as it reads to you, but it's not ideal. I would like it to be just the regular article. But again, there are playback speeds here, so you can control how fast it speaks. And if you hit the little icon on the left, you can see all the voices. So there's quite a few. Some of these are provided by OpenAI. Some of these are provided by other companies. I don't really know all the other ones, but I like Echo. Echo is really good. Nova is very good as well. Basically, all of them are pretty darn good. And you can change your language or there's different voices there. You can hear previews of them here. Again, it's a free app, so I'll let you do that for just the sake of this video's length. I'm not going to show you all of them. There's also this ultra realistic voices. These used to be the best voices in the app. I think some of the new ones are actually better, so you don't even need to use ultra realistic. But yeah, there's tons of these. You can do them with specific accents. Really rad. Text-to-speech is, in my opinion, the best thing about Omnivore. That's the thing it does better than anyone else. So let's go back to the web interface, and you can see, we'll see that same article here. You can see it's actually scrolled. It syncs my position across devices. My highlight is up there, of course, so that all syncs over nicely. In all the interfaces, you can control the look and feel. There's a couple fonts you can choose from. Lore is a really good one. Atkinson Hyperlegible is also a nice one. I use this on my blog, which I think is very legible and also looks nice. And you can tweak all these other things and change it to the color settings you want. You can justify the text, high contrast, all that good stuff. So you can customize the look and feel however you'd like. There's keyboard shortcuts for a lot of this. So if I'm done with this article, I can hit E. They do a lot of Gmail style shortcuts. So if you know those, you'll know these pretty well. It's not obvious where you add a link on the web interface. You actually hit your profile icon up here and do add link, and then you get this. I don't know why that's not anywhere here in the UI, but that's the way it is. Again, some quirks to the interface. You have some saved searches over here. There's highlights. So there's a bespoke interface for how highlights work, and you can add notes. You can see what you've archived, and then you can actually do these saved searches. I haven't really played with this, but if you have custom filters you want to have over here, you can do that. We'll also take this opportunity to show emails. You can subscribe to newsletters with this. So if you create a new email address, you get this kind of random email, sign up for a newsletter with this email address, and they'll get automatically fed into Omnivore and show up in your inbox. I'm going to delete that so you guys don't send me any funny emails. And feeds, again, if you have an RSS feed that you want to read every single thing from, you can add the feed here, and it's going to automatically add all of those to Omnivore for you automatically. Again, I don't think I read 100% of anything I subscribe to, but if you do, that is going to be a useful feature for you here. Also, I just love their kind of imagery, and they have a nice look. Subscriptions lets you manage all that. You can label things. I don't really do that. You can do pinned searches. I don't really do anything with this. But let's get into integrations. So integrations is the next interesting thing. They have integrations into some of these note-taking apps. We'll show Obsidian in a second because that's the one I actually use. You can sync Pocket, so you can actually import your Pocket library over to Omnivore. There's webhooks you can set up, which are more advanced than I'm ready to get into right now. But you can kind of use that to integrate with basically anything you want. And you can actually sync your highlights over to Readwise as well. But let's do Obsidian, and let's take a look at how that works. So let's pull up Obsidian. I've actually already installed it, but I did add a new highlight just now, so we'll be able to see it in action. So you can basically bring in all of your highlights. You can see a bunch that I've done over here, and I have it customized to pull in the author, the title, the URL, and all of my highlights. And what is you can see over here is there's an Omnivore icon in my sidebar. I'm going to click on this, so we're at the top one. Click to sync, it syncs very quickly, and here's that new highlight that I did, and I have the original URL and everything. And again, I can go ahead and reveal this in the Finder, and it didn't reveal the right thing, but anyway, here's a text file with that highlight, so it's just in plain text on my computer that I can do whatever I want with. I totally own, and I really value that in these services. If I can't sync my highlights and saved links to something else, I probably won't use you. If I go into settings real quick, Omnivore is already plugged in. You can find it in the community plugins. Go to browse and then Omnivore. It's going to be the only one listed. It's by Omnivore, and yeah, pretty good. Very good, actually. And there's a whole bunch of settings. You need an API key, which you generate in the web interface only under this API keys page. So you can see I've actually made a couple of these. We're going to get rid of this one right now. But there's this API key that I'm using in Omnivore. You can do different filters. Let's see, you can edit the front matter. So you might've noticed that there was the ID there. You can change that. Here's the format that I'm using. If I copy this, you can actually reset to the default. The default is fine, but for reasons that are only interesting to me, this format is important. you can have it automatically sync throughout the day. You can tell it where to save them, file name, all this stuff. And you can actually, I think if you go into advanced settings, there's a way. I don't know how to do it now, I'm sorry. I'll maybe put a thing on screen here, but I think there's also a way to actually automatically import the full articles for everything you save to Omnivore. So if you want a text version of everything you save to Omnivore, you can also do that if you don't want just the highlights. So I don't know if there's a real great use case for that, but if you do, you can do that through this plugin, and I'll put instructions on screen here if I figure it out. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I will say one of the things that frustrates me about how the app works is if we go back to the iPhone, and I'm kind of like reading along. Let's get the audio out of here. I'm reading, and let's say I'm done with the article. I've gotten the point. How do I archive this? There's nothing at the bottom. There's nothing at the top. You actually have to scroll a decent amount, hit the three dots, and then hit archive up here. Or the only time you get to do it with one tap is when you're all the way at the bottom of an article. You can archive, delete, tag it, or what is this? Clubs. I don't really know what that is. But anyway, I find it a little annoying that you can't archive as easily with one tap like you can in other apps. I sometimes have issues with highlighting. I select some text and then it highlights a different amount of that text. It doesn't do the whole thing. There's some issues with Omnivore, but it's completely free and is pretty darn good most of the time. So yeah, check it out at the link in the description, and I'll see you here next time. Bye-bye.